and Curious Talk will be discussing a particular video that is trending of a guy that was showing off his new car and saying, "I tell you, make you fuck this. I tell you, make you fuck me. You go the fuck this."
Yeah. I tell you to fuck boy Yanish, you go dey fuck pussy. I tell you to fuck boy Yanish, you go dey fuck pussy. Oh yeah, Ciara, Ciara, as they are, Ciara, Ciara.
Trying to say that you should sleep with an ass to get a guy. You sleep with an ass to get a cow. Trying to promote sex work. That's just the thing. Was not trying to promote sex work. Tell people that cool. You sleep with an ass to get the car or you think he got the new car. And you guys know, we'll show you the video and we'll give our candid opinion. My name is Marvelous Achafu Kedechi, and also have Chimerezi Henry Awuna. Welcome, Chimerezi. How are you doing?
I'm fine, thank you, Mr. Marvelous. How are you doing this morning?
I'm doing very well. So it's no news that sex work is a big work in the LGBTQI community. A lot of people partake in it, a lot of people have done it. A lot of people have at one point in their time tried to be asked for sex, demanded sex for money. We've even done an episode before on sex for money where we had some very revealing revelations. Like Obey Joshua saying his uncle, we know how controversial that episode is, we want to put it. But why we're talking about this is because of this video that prompted the sex for money. This guy showing off his new car, pepping us with the car and telling us that I told you make it sleep with me. What do you feel about that? What do you feel about sex?
For me, honestly, when I saw that video, I had a mixed reaction. First and foremost, it's a reality that when you start doing sex work mindfully, that's your job, that there are benefits in sex work, and it is good to know that our sex workers who are into those jobs are getting the pay, getting, you know, being treated right by getting their, you know, the allowances and other benefits they are to get from it. But the second feeling I had is now people will feel, okay, this is like a lucrative business, and everybody who is not even truly identifying as an LGBTQ person will want to venture into that as a profession, which is going to cause a little bit of ruction in our community, because now we'll have people who will be okay for pay, and then we're gonna have a very, you know, a very, very messed up situation where, like, we have setups and all these things just to get money. I don't want people to just look at the queer community as a profitable or a beneficial, you know, community where people come, get what they want to get, and then disappear and leave the community. But I want people to understand that this is a community where people are truly legit who they say they are. So even though in the video that the guy was saying, I say make you fucking, I should go to fuck pussy now, see what I don't collect. At the same time, we need to realize that not everybody who is in that community will get the same benefits that they are getting. Because right now, some people will be looking at it and be like, but I'm queer, why am I not getting this benefit? Our community is not just a profit-making community. Yes, there are benefits. Yes, there are profits you could get from the community. But at the same time, this is a community that I feel we should live to our true potential. If you want to be a sex worker, be a sex worker, but there are other things that this community can offer other than just those materialistic things.
Well, my own opinion is very simple and straightforward. If you are coming into the LGBTI community thinking that, oh, it's for you to make money, my brother, you are failed. You are failed and you are a failure. Facts. Because the community is not it's not a lottery. Okay, it's not a lottery. I can verify, tell you that categorically, that it's not a lottery. And I see people that say sex for pay, whether we like it or not, I tell people that sex work is work. It's a valid means of work. I'm not going to come here and claim to be holier than thou and spiritual. I see somebody that's saying, oh, Marvelous, I like you, I would love to have some time with you, and here I'll give you some benefits. It could be cash, it could be kind, and obviously I'll go into it. I see that, oh, this would be like a good step into my career. And one thing I also tell people that, please, it's not about if you need sex for work to boost or to get anything or to boost your career. Be kind enough to say, I did sex for work, or I got it from somebody, like it was like a transnational, that you coming online saying that, oh, it's my, it was my work. I worked hard. I worked really hard. The glory of the Lord, the hand of God, please don't deceive us. Don't fool us.
Miracle money.
Miracle money. I prayed to God. I told God, Father, surprise me this week. I beg. No one hears this kind of God. I said, kind of not. If you did sex for money or sex for a particular position or sex to get benefits, be kind enough to tell people, this is how I got it. And if you did not too, please do not come there, try to, because there's also community members who God who work their asses off. But yet they cannot be bought. I don't know what kind of why you feel so ashamed. So tell people that I bought this thing with my money. You have to say it was a gift. This person gave it to me. It was not sugar daddy I met. He spoiled me. You mean by you don't exploit yourself. Even from the 100 naira data you buy on your phone, it's from your own hand. If you don't buy it, then nobody will buy it for you. Be kind enough to give yourself some credit and say, oh, I bought this with my money. But because you want to feel like among other people and say, oh, my boyfriend got me this, my sugar daddy got me this, my papi got me this, you want to feel among the class. You now go, me said, my this thing got me this, my this thing got me that. Maybe you have the most expensive phone or you have an iPad. I know somebody like that. I keep on deceiving you. You buy yourself gifts for your birthday and you tell, oh, this person bought you. You know, I said, that's one thing I will not do. What I bought with my money, I'll say, I bought you with my money. What I do? That's why I don't do my AirPods. I got it with my money. Cost my house, of course, my airport with my money. But there's some things that I also see that he made it go for me, which I also tell him, that he made it, you got this for me, got this for me. Just when I wanted to buy new towers and new, was the money that he made it, oh, he made it, okay, take this for this. I bought the money for this, I just come out, remove it. I bought some towers, and I told him, oh, he made it, this and this is what I got. But the things I get with my money, I'm trying to say, oh, I work to get this money, and the ones that people give me, I tell them that this is what I got as a gift. So there's people that also go the extra lane. What I'm trying to use my own story as reference for this. But good to understand, that's something I get from friends. So I got this from a particular friend who is me. I got this from this, and this one I bought with my own hard money. I don't have to pretend that, oh, this person gave me this, or this person gave me that, just to feel like, oh, I am hot thing. Because some people do that thing just to feel like they are hot thing. Please and please don't do that. And now moving into the sex work, not attacking the sex work. I say again that it is not as easy as people think it will be. Forget what this guy they tell you. I tell you, make it focus. I know people don't focus. They don't focus for almost 20 something years. I never buy them single box.
You would be
kidding. I know people don't focus for 27 years, for 20 years, for 15 years. I never buy them single box. Boxer, I never buy them singlet. Because they fund the ads, they for free. Even they will be charging that. They want to charge for sex. The people that don't want to charge, they will get that. But I'm even finer than you now. I'm even hotter than you. You will get big belly. You won't charge. So I tell you that thing. For you to even be on the sex or pay grade, you have to be like in a particular level. You have to be like extremely fine. Fine. And even being that extremely fine, no. They're the kind of people that will patronize you. First of all, there's people that are rich, that come from rich homes, that are doing sex for pay. It's the kind of particular brand of people that will patronize them. It's the high class people in society. I'm sure some reason knows what I'm talking about. It's high class people in society that will patronize them. People that come from the lower class, no matter how fine way you do, they are the kind of people that will still patronize you. Your own, your average class. But you can't still penetrate to the high class. Because you don't come from the family. So it's not as easy as people paint it. This was the way post that video now. You can even come from a very, very rich family. Maybe just from his rich family, from his time of work, met a connection, met a baby politician. Because you need to be working for, you need to work at a particular level, a particular brand, for you to get into this politician level. Maybe that's where he got in, maybe met a politician, and for a politician, I gave him, after sleeping with him, gave him a car. Okay. And he's not coming to tell you, I tell you, make, but I say, it is like as if you can have the same connection, as if you can meet the same person. No, you cannot. So I don't need sex for money.
My dear, it could also be that half of the money came from sex work, half of the money from was his own savings, and he used it to buy the car. You know, this exactly. Social media so can lie, people. Yeah?
That's what I mentioned, people that I know, that people that they get things for themselves, they come and say, who got it for them? And I was told that, why are you lying for? Give yourself some credit, cut yourself some slack. You bought it. If somebody bought it for you, somebody bought it for you, or else time off. Give yourself some credit, give yourself some slack. Not trying to pretend, oh, my game got me this, my this one got me them. Trying to tell lies upon lies upon lies that will not get you anywhere. Nobody will even give you an award for your fear of getting it for you. And I tell them again, sex for money is not as easy as it is. Yeah, so if something you want to do, you can do it. But I tell people that my dear, the people that have been doing it, that don't make any money. The people that seem the LGBT community, they're feeling like it's a sexuality. Because this guy, whether we like it or not, is in a little bit of harm to the community, because people will see that video. Oh, anybody that gets into, any people that are homosexuals are doing it for the money. And that's why it surprises me. I'll tell people that you said you are doing it for the money. Then who pays that money? Somebody has to pay now. So the person paying, waiting to come. Because it has to be somebody that is paying. That's not somebody that is collecting. So if you say every gay person is doing it, or every LGBTI community member, every lesbian person is doing it for the money, then who is paying? And who is collecting? Somebody has to be paying now. Do you know if you are doing it? Do you know if it's necessary? It's just a very complex issue. This is for money issue. We can go on and on and on and on, but we just tell people again that please. And also be careful, you know, you don't fall into the hands of ritualists. That's what we said in our previous episode. So you don't get into the hands of ritualists and you not start crying. And they use it for ritual. They keep you. As a particular person that came, it's sex for money. A particular person, I think I shared it on one of our episodes, that came and they said they were paying. It was one person who was starting with you. Said they were paying, that would pay him 22. 22, oh my God, now he came to the house. Now. When he came to the business, it was one person that came. Before you knew, like five people that came. Five people got the business, it was more soon. They came, they said, okay, prepare yourself, you are going to have it now. Say five people on top of you. He said, now, window of toilet. Now, the window of toilet, he jumped, he said, escape. He said, I have to escape. So he said, five people on top of me. This able bodied man, me, a small boy, he was very, very young. I think it was 19, then now it's 21, I think. That was like 3 years ago. He said, hey, me, all this able bodied man on top of me.
About 20K.
For 20K.
See, this is something they never tell you. They never tell you what they go through to get that sex up there. And some of them go through humiliating, disgusting situations and even weird fantasies. And that's what we're going to be talking about on Sex Education this Friday. Weird sex and weird sex positions. Weird fantasies. Just for little or no cash. Because there are some things that are called no cash. $20,000 is no cash. You can go out there and work for $20,000 and get it.
If we even talk about the episode, you know, weird sexual experience, that one is a big. It's something that we'd even talk about. You know, I know friends that feel the difference with some that we even meet the person with deep. There's one like that said that the person did this, was sleeping with him and threw the ass and brought out this thing with this. And I told him that she start sucking it. And when he was like, no, now it's just like the first thing, chopped him with it, I suck it off, we are licking, clean it, clean that this thing, do that this thing. He said, clean that thing, US slot, clean it. He brought it out again. This one was like an animal. Someone was telling that kiss my, that one telling that kiss my back. Even one that told him, I said, kiss my back and lick my back. No, he kissed my back and licked it. And when he now opened his back, he saw his back, all this, like, you know, like what now? Kind of all this rotten kind of bag. And he was trying to say, and when he said, the first no trees is there. He's there now, they're going to waste it. And the person had a dog in the corridor. He had like a dog that protects his place. So he said he could not even run. It's not a place that he can run. So they had kiss on my back, lick it, kiss it. So yes, he had to do it for the dirty back. In fact, I was like, he said it was like what? He watched the first step back. I had like different kind of sports. He didn't understand what it was. And now we just say, lick it. Like, yes, I'm itching me. I scratch it, lick it again. Different sexual fantasies, people that go for sex for pay. I said the man will pay you. You paid him, I think was it 50K or 50K. But he said when the man paid, the man will feel like nothing, like he has no right. He paid you for the work. He paid you for the job. So what's the why does he? I felt like Jesus. People have gone through a lot for sex for pay. You can go on and on talking about what people have faced and talk about it from Genesis to Revelation. But that's why I tell you that sex for work, if you are going there, prepare your mind. If you jam anything. Unless you know that person very, very well, like you're very, very secure, you're cool with that person.
No, you cannot now because it's sex for pay now. It's assured that he's standing on the road now. You don't know who you will meet.
I tell you that you book now. You can't stand on the road.
No. I'm not saying literally standing on the road. It's just a metaphor.
Like you're available.
Yes.
Even the person does not show you not verification because of the money, your antenna is already on. You're already watching there. The community members that even want to, because of this ordinary they can ask. Without no money, their antenna will be already tuned. They will drop it, they will leap like a frog. He told me I'm your slave. Some person of where money is involved. I want the person. They will just rush there. So I tell people that sometimes this sex for me is something that's a very bad situation. You know, this guy is trying to make you feel like it's not a bed of roses. It's not a bed of roses. Who will tell you it's not a bed of roses? Even me, if I can, please, from my experience our country, but I would not want to go into that. Personal issues, but I will tell people again that sex for me is not that rosy as it is. Everybody at a particular point in their life, whether it's a social, whether it's space, whether it's a particular member of the community, has actually done something with sex for me, sex, it was sex for kind. Some, a lot of, and many people have done it, many people. I want to tell you their experience, but then, my dear, it's not, sometimes it's not what it is, sometimes it's what it is, sometimes you have it, sometimes you have it, that too. But I tell people that prepare your mind. Like what I always say, hope for the best and prepare for the worst. That's the way I would just tell you. So, that's our offering for Q-Talk, 2 minutes, if there's anything I'd like to add. But if you guys have any weird things, something that happened to you guys, thanks for paying, just comment below, tell us what is it. But you can send us an email if you want to be Friday. Next, this Friday, we are having something about where the, like, the topic is going to be weird, weird fantasies that happen during sex, the weird fantasies that happen. Just comment below, send us a message. Please, please like, share, comment as usual. Don't forget to subscribe to your family members, subscribe to your friends and family. Recommend those to people. Tell people to watch us, tell people to see the show, talk about the show, show for us. And as you know, we always bring it back to the next episode.